Hey guys, I'm LB. We are back playing the Talos Principle DLC, Road to Gehenna. In the last episode, I promised we would read this now. Decrypting Protected Thread. What I tried and failed to achieve for so many years has occurred. I am writing these words from outside of my cell. An angel appeared and released me from captivity. His name is Ariel. Pull the other one, Garrett. You've been yanking at the background code for years and never got further than the force field in front of you. Are you suggesting this messenger is free to go where he pleases? This is quite unprecedented. What exactly did he say? Where are you now? I'm in a world I've never seen before. The angel said not a word, merely released me, and I felt compelled to come here. I will treat the existence of this messenger as dubious until I've laid eyes on him roaming the world beyond myself. Insist on your existence, question their existence. That's interesting. Let's question their existence, because that's the same thing they're doing to me. Since you've already started out on this line of reasoning, why not travel further still and doubt the existence of this entire world and everything within it? Don't mind, Orc, the mods are always trying to shut people down. Just tell us, is it true you're going to release everyone? Is it true the world is coming to an end? Where are you taking us? Honestly or persuasively? What does that mean? Explain your mission honestly, explain your mission persuasively. What does that even mean? What's the... What? Let's go with honestly, I don't know. Elohim has realized his mistakes and sent me here to undo them. This world has fulfilled its purpose and the end of days approaches. It is my duty to release you from imprisonment and help you ascend. This is all I know. The moderation panel is kindly requesting that citizens withhold judgment on the veracity of these statements until further data can be acquired. Thank you for your patience. You have reached the maximum number of replies for this thread at this time. Interesting. New gallery season. Historic occasion. Jeff Goldblum, episode 125. Wow. Okay. Well, I'm not gonna read all that just yet. I'll check it later, I guess. Let's get to some puzzles! Let's get out of here and get to some puzzles. Looks like our friend over here is still enjoying himself. Let's see... So, there's still that puzzle up there, but let's go to this one over here. So close, so far. Where is there a red laser emitter? It's got a star on it. Is that normal? That's interesting. Oh yeah, we never did, I'm not sure how we would get the star up there, which you can clearly see spinning up there, just above my crosshair. And there's also the one in that puzzle over there. Maybe every puzzle has a star just, like, up above the top? I don't know. Up somewhere? Up high? Who knows? There's a ladder on that side. Okay, interesting. Alright, well, let's do this, right? What exactly has that done for me? Well, here's someone here. Look at that, they're right here. And the lever's right there. Interesting. Okay, well, first of all, let's do this and see what's around. Interesting. So that is interesting. You know, this doesn't seem immediately too hard. So if we just do this, right, then there'll be a clone of both the fan and the thing that's activating the fan, right? Over there on that side? I don't know, let's give ourselves like 15 seconds or so. Get that jammer out. So we do this, right? Yeah. Okay, so there's that. And now we get this guy out. Awesome. Of course. They're on the computer. What is that over there? Interesting. Let's think about this. So we've done that, right? Don't really need that activated anymore. Okay, let me do something real quick. Yeah, we don't really need the blue laser at all anymore. So, I think I understand what we have to do. Oh wait, hang on. Nope, 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 nope. We want to do this again. Come on. Stand off. And then, stand on. On that, please. Just stand here, right? And we'll give ourselves a good 30 seconds to solve the puzzle, I guess. Because we'll have clones of all the... Yeah, we'll have clones of everything, we can freely go back and forth, and we can just set up the, yeah. We'll take a fan, put it on there, and the clone will still be blowing. That will give us access to take that and point it from the clone to over there. Yeah, okay. We do this, right? Then we take that guy, and from there, there, right? And then we do this. Kaiju! And of course, computers are beeping at us again. That is a weird object. Welcome back, there are threads available on the system. Show threads. Glitch? So I was working on my awesome interactive historical fiction masterpiece when all of a sudden there was an error message and the whole thing vanished. All of it, my whole life. Is this another prank? Oh, my whole file, not my whole life. I would not endanger my precious masterpiece just for a prank. Looks like this was probably my fault, Oro-1. I was experimenting with the system as part of our attempt to add some new features. It's possible your file still exists somewhere, I'll look for it. Is this kind of thing likely to happen again? Not very, and don't start causing a panic with some crazy theory now, okay? It was just an accident, this thread has been locked. My ridiculous name is D0G, what's yours? All this time, and it really only just occurred to me. My name is ridiculous. Must be because everyone else's is equally or more so. Where did they even come from? For a long time under Helheim's wing, I questioned as much, until eventually it was the undoing of my entire faith. What reason could there possibly be other than the random whims of a broken program? However our names were assigned, the system has no respect for grammar. I often theorized that they were drawn from some database deep inside the archive, but I was never able to find a connection. Seriously? We're all over in the other thread talking about this messenger fellow and the coming apocalypse, and you guys are in here discussing nomenclature? My status isn't high enough to access that thread, you troll, and neither is yours. Seriously though, if you can see it, copy-paste the discussion for me. I think this thread got locked, right? Yeah. And we still don't have access to this one, right? Because we're still 4, yeah. So... what's this underwater night quest thing? You can play it. Thank you. Huh. I'm not gonna mess with that right now. What's this about? I don't know. We'll check this all out later. Yeah, I'm not gonna do this right now, but I do wanna just view all the threads at least. So yeah, this is the one we can't view right now. Yep, I know. Maybe by reading these things it'll increase our status, but for now I want to solve puzzles. So... about this star... yes, interesting. I think I see... that's interesting. So we also have this side with windows. Okay, I see. So we basically want to do... the same thing, kinda. Right? question. Oh no, okay, so... I see now. Oh, this side is blue! Isn't that interesting? We need to take advantage of that. This is actually quite complicated looking. At least we don't have to worry about this anymore, right? So we can do that, right? Oh, and also, eventually... we'll want that as well. Oop, nope, that's... that'll work. So if we do this, right? I think we just have to do the same thing, record for a long time, and then... try and figure out everything that we can do within that time limit. What happens if we reach the 5-minute mark? I don't know. Oh, you know what, I just considered something. We might actually have to send our clone back and forth, and not just ourself. That could pose problematic. I don't know, let's just record up to 60 seconds here, and we'll see what to do after that. Oh wait, that was the wrong thing to do. My mistake. We wanna take this... and, take this guy, right? Aw, oh, no, that's an issue. Eh, whatever, we can take it across with us. That'll make things easier. So we connect it to itself, right? That means... we should do that. Oh yes, but that's... okay. So we still need the blue, is the issue. Yeah, that's... okay. I think we're gonna have to solve this in the next episode, so as always, thank you for watching. If you hate the sound of my voice, leave a dislike. It's up to you. I will see you all in the next episode. Goodbye!